Hi everybody, it's Miss Barnacle again. Now we're going to be multiplying mixed numbers. I've put a few of these examples up on the board, and so I'm going to help you work them out. I'm noticing this slide, we're talking about doubling ingredients in a recipe. So this is something that we always want to know how to do, and I'm going to show you how to make that easier. Okay, let me go to the board. If we have 2 1/4 cups of brown sugar and we want to double that so that we can make a bigger recipe, there's a couple of things that we have to do. The first thing you need to understand is that the whole number 2 has an understood 1 in the denominator. So every time you see a whole number, you want to automatically put a 1 in the denominator when you're going to do multiplication or division for that matter, because it makes it easier to deal with. And the next thing that you want to do is, we did a rule earlier when we were introduced to fractions and mixed numbers where we took a mixed number and changed it to an improper fraction. Anytime you're going to multiply or divide, you always want to make sure that you change your fractions into your mixed numbers to improper fractions before you do this. It makes it a whole lot easier. So you want to do 4 times 2. Remember, this is multiplication. Multiply. I'm going to abbreviate that, M-U-L-T, multiply. 4 times 2 to give you 8. And 8 plus the numerator, 1, gives you 9. So now you have 9/4 multiplied to 2/1. Okay, once you get it to this way, this is just like what we did in the previous module. Look and see if there's any way that you can reduce this. And I can. I can reduce the 2 and the 4. 2 divides into 2 once. 2 divides into 4 twice. Once you've done all your reducing, then you multiply top times top and bottom times bottom. So when I multiply top times top, I get 9 times 1 is 9. And then 2 times 1 is 2. Now, that gives me 9/2. And if I was just going to have this as fractions or improper, that would be great. But when you're talking about cups of brown sugar, you don't measure 9/2 cups. You always want to make sure that it's a measurement that is accurate to what you're doing. Since you are doing measuring brown sugar, you want to turn that improper fraction back into a mixed number. So you have to remember that rule. To turn that back into a mixed number, what do? You divide. 2 divides into 9 4 times, which makes 8. And then when you subtract, that leaves you 1 left over. So that's 4 1/2. So when I take 2 1/4 and I double that recipe, now I have, and I ran out of room, I'll erase this, 4 1/2 cups of brown sugar. So now I want to do the next one. I have 1 1/3 cups of peanut butter. So again, you want to change this mixed number to an improper fraction. So that would be 3 times, because we're going to multiply, 3 times 1 is 3, plus 1 makes 4. So that would be 4/3 times 2/1. Look and see if there's anything you can reduce. Can I? Absolutely not. So I do top times top, bottom times bottom. And since we are doing cups of peanut butter, you don't measure 8/3 cups of peanut butter. So you want to make sure you turn that back into a mixed number. So 3 divides into 8 2 times, which makes 6. I subtract and that gives me 2. So that's 2 2/3. So let me write that bigger so you can see that. 2 2/3 cups of peanut butter. So anytime you're going to double the recipe or you're adding inches together or anything like that, when it's a measurement, you always want to make sure that you know how to change it to a mixed number so that it makes sense. Okay, now I'm going to do just a random problem. Let me erase. So we have 3 1/2. Times 10 times 1 1/5. Okay, Again, you want to make sure that you take your mixed numbers and turn them into improper fractions. So that would be 2 times 3 is 6. Plus 1 makes 7. So that would be 7 over 2 times all whole numbers. Remember, we just talked about that. All whole numbers will have a 1 under them in the denominator. So that would be 10 over 1 times 5 multiplied to 1 makes 5, plus 1 makes 6, so that's 6 fifths. Now we start our reducing process. So we say, okay, looking at my top numbers, because I always look at the top first, does 7 have anything in common with 2, 1, and 5? No. So I go to the next one, 10. Does 10 have anything in common with 2, 1, or 5? It does. 10 and 5 have something in common. It's a 5. 5 divides into 5 once. 5 divides into 10 2 times. Okay? Now I'm going to look at what's left. I have a 6. 6 and 2 have something in common. They have a 2. So 2 divides into 2 once. 2 divides into 6 3 times. And when I look at this now, all of my denominators are 1s. So I can't do anything else with them. So I multiply the tops. 7 times 2, which is 14. And 14 times 3, if you don't automatically know, do the math. 14 times 3, 3 times 4 makes 12, carry the 1. 3 times 1 makes 3, plus 1 makes 4. So the answer is 42. Okay, and that's all we have on multiplying mixed numbers.